Given the timing, I think this video was taken on February 16.
Yes, it was taken last February.
But on March 15, 2 days before our withdrawal from the International Criminal Court took effect, two former officials of the Philippines submitted a communication.
Yes.
Others would like to interpret that in layman's terms, simply as a complaint, for all intents and purposes.
Yes.
So, are you planning to somehow make use of this documentation of yours to help boost that communication before the ICC?
Yes.
Can that be done?
Yes, we're going. Yes, definitely. Yes, we can offer it, of course, to Justice Carpio Morales and
Ombudsman,
former Ombudsman Carpio Morales, and it's her decision. It's their complaint. If they want to use it, they can go to the area where we went to, and they can talk to the Fisher folks themselves. Will that boost their case? Yes, definitely, because this is one more proof of the harassment. And we are willing to share it with them, because the issue here is no longer about anything else. It's the issue of helping our Fisher folks, be protected, and their livelihoods be protected.
But the focus of their communication is the environmental damage done by the land reclamation by China, I think between 2013 and 2016.
It also includes the deprivation of livelihood.
So that can be incorporated.
Of Fisher folks. Yeah, that can be. Their cause of action, I scanned their complaint, includes the environmental. But of course, a major part there is the, they call it the persecution, inhumane acts, like harassment and depriving our Fisher folks of their livelihood in the area.
But even then, other experts are saying that it would be a very difficult case to build, or communication to turn into an actual case to be investigated by the ICC, simply because of that particular fact that you're trying to encompass environmental crime as a crime against humanity, which should fall under the ambit of the Rome Statute.
Look, Christian, I took my PhD at the University of Melbourne on the International Criminal Court. I wasn't able to finish my PhD, unlike other candidates who may claim that they finished something when they haven't. I studied well. In the crime against humanity, there are certain provisions that can be used. Environmental damage is one.
Even if it's not direct?
Well, directly or indirectly, when you attack crimes against humanity is an attack against civilians with knowledge of the attack, no? And the attack against civilians, for example, could constitute persecution, deprivation of livelihood, for example. And then it causes damage, environmental damage of a severe and permanent nature. Then it is a crime against humanity under the Rome Statute. So it's there. It's there in one of the, if you look at the various acts under the Rome Statute, It can be included there. Of course, also included in war crimes and
genocide
and so on.
Acts of aggression.
Yes, the latest is acts of aggression.
But, but